Thank you. You got, come down, come down. I can't believe you have an opportunity to be here with these guys and you're all like 50 miles away. All right, does anyone have a question for any one of these folks up on the panel?
Don't ask anything, we don't have any answers.
You have a question? No? Well, come on, start it off, you must have one.
What inspired you guys to start throwing this festival?
I didn't mean to shoot my
grandma. Maybe not for you.
Don't be put off by that.
I've been a zombie for years.
Better ask some questions or we'll start singing and that's really scary.
Well, I'll try to answer your first question. Maybe that'll inspire some more. I think it's just exactly what's happening. There are fans. We do have a gentleman here from France. We have people here from New Jersey, from Michigan. And this is kind of the light end of the group right now because you guys are the ones that had to travel for the most part, and you're here because you had to plan to get here. I think tonight and tomorrow you're going to see a lot more of the locals show up. But this is Night of the Living Dead. We hope to have this next year and years to come. We'll just fill this whole place.
This is more of a statement and a question to Judy. First, I want to thank you for coming. I've wanted to meet you since I started collecting autographs many, many years ago. And what took you so long?
I'm still trying to wrap my head around the fact that people want to meet me. I'm very flattered.
Judith, I've had very little to do with the movie since it came out. I've enjoyed being part of it. But I was never really actively involved until they approached me about an interview for Autopsy of the Dead. And then I found out so much about what had gone on in the movie. I had no idea until I did the interview that I was the last ghoul to be killed. I had no idea.
What's the strangest question or the strangest request you've ever gotten from a fan? Be honest.
Wow. Well, very often, there are fans who know more about the picture than we do, because many of the fans have made careers out of studying it frame by frame by frame.
Well, I'm going to make this short. It's a long story, but it's the best one I've heard. And it was 1993. We were in Buffalo, New York, and it was the 25th anniversary of Night of the Living Dead, and we were the featured guests at this big convention. And this one lady jumped all over me for plugging some wires in near her booth. And so I just took the heat and told her off, and about 200 people gave me a standing ovation because nobody liked her. So then her husband the next day charged over, and I thought, he's going to hit me right in the mouth now, and he has a big belly, so maybe if I hit him in his big beer belly, he'll go down. So his hand came out, and instead of punching me, he shook hands, and he said, he told me this whole story, but again, I'll cut it short. The net thing was that he told me his son was 25 years old and was conceived in the back seat of his car at the drive-in while he and his wife were watching Night of the Living Dead. And he said it rather apologetically. I think he was trying to tell me that that's why he had to marry that bitch.
This is another question for Judy. Now, have people ever come up to you asking you if you were the lady in Night of the Living Dead?
No.
No?
No. Unless I told them, or unless I'm in the city, yes. Everybody knew. It's a small town. But out of state, nobody really knows. Unless I tell them.
Well, Judy has had enough harassment from her own son and daughter, though, to make up for all of those fans who haven't harassed her.
Hey, Russ. Russ had a really great experience. I think it's funny when we were making a film about Willie Stargell, and Russ went when they won the World Series. Why don't you tell that? That's good. That's a good story.
This is an absolute true story. We were in the Pirates locker room after the World Series. And we had done some interviews and that kind of thing with various players. And it was I'm going to guess probably 2 or maybe 2.5 hours after the game was over, and everyone felt, well, probably it's, the fans will have all gone, we'll be able to get to our cars and so forth. So we walked out with a group of baseball players, but sure enough, there were still fans waiting for baseball player autographs. And this young 14-year-old African-American girl asked me for my autograph. And I said, thank you very much, but I'm not a ball player, but thanks for asking. And she looked up at me and she said, I know, but you were in Night of the Living Dead. And I said, sweetheart, that gets you an autograph. True story.